Okay.
Then my beloved brothers and sister, الجلوس بين السجدتين. What I should say when I sit down like this? What I will say? اللهم اغفر لي وارحمني وعافني واجبرني وارزقني. And this is the five things is mentioned in the dua. I can say, oh Allah, forgive me and cover all my issues, take care about all my issues and give me a rizq, اغفر لي وارحمني and have mercy on me. All this, we can say that kind of dua when between the sujood and when we sit down to the sujood. Very important, my beloved brothers and sisters, to make your back straight. Don't bend like this, Allahu Akbar, half of the way, then you go sujood again. It's wrong. Your salah is not valid. Some people say, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. It's like a bouncing, like bouncing. It's not bouncing. You have to sit down properly. You have to sit down properly, brothers and sisters, and make sure your back is straight and relaxed. الطمأنينة. Remember the word together. Say with me, طمأنينة. 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 What does mean طمأنينة? That the right timing or right moment of timing in every position of salah. You give the right timing moment for every position in the salah. Relax. If you miss the tumanina in any position of salah, your salah is not acceptable. Your salah is not acceptable. There's one sahabi, he came and he prayed to rak'ah. He came to give salam to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when he came to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he gave him salam. Rasul sallallahu gave him salam back and he said, irji' fasalli, go back, repeat your salah, fa'innaka lan tusalli. Indeed, you did not perform any salah. He did two rak'ah. Nabi sallallahu said, go repeat your salah. Your salah is not acceptable. Then he went and he does again two rak'ah and he come back to give salam to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he give him salam. He said, go repeat again, second time. Your salah is not valid. Ya Allah. Then he repeat again, third time. Then he came to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, ya Rasulullah, salamu alaykum. He said, go back, repeat your salah. Indeed, you don't know, you did not do salah. He said, ya Rasulullah, allimni, teach me. I don't know, that's what I can know. That's what I know. Then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he taught him. He said, you have to perform your wudu and come. And every position, اطمئن حتى تعتدل قائما. اطمئن حتى تعتدل من السجود. اطمئن, اطمئن, اطمئن. He mentioned the word اطمئن mean give right moment of relaxing in every position you perform in the salah. So this is really, really important. And you have to do salah in order. You have to do standing before ruku'. Don't say, Allahu Akbar, I want to do ruku' first, then I will do standing again. No, you have to do salah in order. You have to do salah, first standing, then ruku', then sujood. Then stand again. Then ruku', then sujood. Then sit down, tashahhud, first tashahhud. Then stand again, then ruku', then sujood. Then stand again, then standing, then ruku', stand from ruku', then sujood. So this is a tartib. Tartib means in order. And tumanina in every position. Very, very important, my beloved brothers and sisters. Then I come down again for sujood. Allahu Akbar. Subhana Rabbi al-A'la, Subhana Rabbi al-A'la, Subhana Rabbi al-A'la. As I told you, you have to close your foot from the back, man or woman, even man. Huh? Good, he asked a question. If you do like this, it's wrong. To the man, it's wrong. You have to close your foot. Okay? Make sure it's together, all right? Jazakum Allah khair. After the second sujood, then I do the second rak'ah normally as the first rak'ah. Then the final is at-tashahhud. Final what? Tashahhud. When I want to perform only two rak'ah, I do tashahhud. Tashahhud, this is very common mistakes. If you can see me, my beloved brothers and sisters, it's very important. Okay. If you can see me, I already did the second rak'ah. Now I am here. now I am here in the after two rak'ah I sit down to do tashahhud. To do what? Tashahhud. First tashahhud, my eyes, where is my sujood? And there is a different way to you to make my hands. Okay, the first way is barid and sunnah from Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. I put the right ibham, this finger, with this the middle finger together, and this is up like this, straight. Okay, straight. This is one of the way. 3, 1, 2, the inside, and this one together, and this one straight like this. This has a hadith. Also moving this one, there's also another hadith. I can move it. Okay? Also, third way is also valid, as a sunnah mentioned, that I put like this, three finger together, then this one like that. And I do like that. I can move or I just straighten it. Both is valid. You see like that? Also mentioned from the Sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also, there is another way, number four, like this. Finger inside and three hand in the top. And this one also tashahhud. You understand? This is number what? Four. Number five, also valid. I straight my hands like this, I straight like this. Then I lift only the sababa, tashahhud. Huh? Also, this is valid. Now, five different ways, all is sunnah, and it's a mention, it's correct. This one, together, moving, or just straighten it. Or this one, together, moving, or straighten it. Or this one inside, like this, straighten it, or move it. Or the last one, straight, and this only up. All this way, it's valid in the tashahhud. التحيات لله and this is what we say التحيات لله والصلوات الطيبات السلام على النبي ورحمة الله وبركاته السلام علينا وعلى عباد الله الصالحين أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. This one is واجب, obligatory. If someone he sit down and he need to say the تشهد, your salah is not valid. You understand? Very important to know that dua and to do that position. About the legs, my right foot straight to the Qibla, and this one I sit on it. Okay, that's how the first tashahhud after two rak'ah. In the last tashahhud, if I pray four rak'ah, I do like that. This one should be under, and this one to the Qibla. Huh? Okay, and my head is straight. My head is straight. This is the last tahiyyat. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala al-Muhammad kama sallayta ala Ibrahim wa ala al-Ibrahim wa barak ala Muhammad wa ala al-Muhammad kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala al-Ibrahim innaka hamidu majid. This is the last tashahhud. That is the position. Okay, the sunnah for the last tashahhud. Last tashahhud. Can you see, your sisters, brothers? Some people, they make mistake, they do like that. They bend their head down like this. It's not correct. You have to straighten your back. Or they do like that. It's wrong. Or they do like that. Look how many hits they take. The one next to them, he will run away. It's not correct. You have to keep your balance with the people next to you. So the line will not become expanded. You understand? I'm not so fit, so forgive me. 20 years ago, I used to do it very well. Now, we gain weight, alhamdulillah. So this is the sunnah, you straighten. Sometimes as an imam, I just do like this, because I found it a little bit difficult. If it's very difficult or you are sick, it's okay to sit down like that. But if you are able to do it, it's extra credit, because you try to combine with the sunnah of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But don't damage your legs. Then this is not the sunnah. If you cannot walk after this, make sure you are healthy. You don't have a broken legs. Someone, he has already operation and he wants to do the sunnah, then he break his legs again. This is not the sunnah of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this is the way we do the tashahud. Is it clear, my brothers and sisters? Clear about the tashahud? Then we do taslim. What we do? Taslim, we say, there is four different ways. We say, here, I'm doing now taslim. Look at me, I can say, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. The right, little, and the left, I do more. Okay? More. This is one of the way. Also is valid. Another way we say, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh. We can add wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Also, correct. Another way, I can say, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Also, one of the way. Another way, I can say, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Here wa barakatuh, and here only wa rahmatullah. Also valid. All this different picture, if you do it, your salah is valid. Salah is sunnah, compiled with the sunnah of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Like this, little, and this is more, little bit. Because you end the salah, khalas. After this, no anything. It's finished. You complete your salah. After this, my beloved brothers and sisters, is the sunnah to remain sitting in your place with the adhkar. And here, shaitan, subhanallah, he distracts most of us. He remind you something important. Something important. In order to stop doing the dhikr, and you will be busy with something else, and you miss a great reward. One of the highest rewards, the dhikr after salah. Can you imagine how many each dhikr you say after salah? It has so much reward. And the malaika, they still around you, making istighfar for you. As long you are in the place where do you doing waiting for salah or you doing salah, you are in salah. Still accounting the timing, the taxi meter still running with the hasanat. The taxi meter is still running with hasanat. We say, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. Oh Allah, forgive our shortcoming in salawat. Astaghfirullah three times. In order that your salah, whatever missing any part, less khushu', busy, distraction, forgotten, astaghfirullah is, ya Allah, forgive and accept my salah. You understand? Then, Allahumma anta salam, wa minka salam, tabarakta wa ta'alayka ya jalal wa karam, Allahumma anni ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadatik. This hadith is hadith of Mu'adh ibn Jabal, subhanallah, 33 times. Alhamdulillah, 33 times. Allahu Akbar, 33 times. Then, la ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika la, lahu mulku, alhamdulillah, ala kulli shay'in qadir. So I remain in the dhikr. And it's a sunnah, don't move, change your place. It's a common here in our masjid. Everybody finish salah, he just want to move far away. It's not the way. Sunnah to remain in your place. Don't move too close to the one next to. Then you will be distracting if he's still doing salah. And go back too much. And you go back, someone may be praying. You hit him. So remain in your place until the imam he go. Then you go. That's the way. The correct way. And imam, inshallah, it doesn't take too long in order not everybody has something to do. So remain until imam, he finishes dhikr and he starts to move, then the things you can move. You know what I like in Malaysia, somehow they have very nice culture, that the imam remain in dhikr, everybody remain in the line. When the imam stands, they come and gives the imam salam. That's as we will not go until the imam go. Most of them, yeah, of course. This is which is really better way that you remain in your place to the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Unless if you have problem or your legs pain or something, you need to change your place, this is no problem. But try as much you can to remain in your place. And this is advice to women, sisters, you finish the salah, don't go run to the cooking. Stay 5 minutes, please, in the dhikr. 5 minutes at least to show to Allah, I'm still there. Allah, run, bismillah, dunya, take it easy. Just remain little calm, 5 minutes, 10 minutes to dhikr to Allah. When you finish dhikr, go do all your things. You understand? This is really important advice for everyone. Jazakumullah khair. Any question until tashahud? Huh? أنت تشعر بسبب ها؟
السلام عليكم.
الصلاة is valid, بس better السلام عليكم ورحمة الله أو السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته الآخر. Both, that's better. التسليمتين. This is a showing this one.
If you miss out one raka'ah and imam make salam, do you just stand up? You make salam first, then stand up to make out?
No, you start making up after imam finish the salam.
But do you say salam or you don't say salam?
No, don't say salam. Because if you say salam, you're already out of salam. That way is you are out of salam. So make sure if the imam says salam alaykum salam, don't follow imam here. You stand to complete all the missing raka'ah because you're really late. You are come late. Clear, brother? You understand?
Is it just one salam or both salam?
Well,
do I have to wait for two salams by the imam?
After, as a minimum, the first salam. As a minimum. After second salam, no problem. But as minimum, the first salam. Not before. After immediately, okay. Because the first salam is wajib, second sunnah. So make sure that he combine the wajib, then you are free to do. Yes. Any other question? Alhamdulillah. Clear? Is it some comments, mistakes we covered today? Common mistake in Surah Al-Fatiha, in the position, the way you move your finger or something. Because a lot of people angry. You say, this is only the sunnah. No, brother, there's a hadith of this and hadith of this. Or some people, like they pray like that. Why he pray like this, I pray like this. All is correct, has a hadith. And this is a si'atul deen, si'atul la, the wide of Sharia. You know what I mean, wajib Sharia? You have different way to do the things and all is valid. All is valid. To make sure like someone, he is not able to lift his hand like this. Some people like this, some people like this. All is okay. Okay? So this is the beauty of Islam. You have a different, if you're not able to do like you are able to do this, this is, everybody make him more comfortable to one of the ways to do. And if you do it time to time, to change it as to remind yourself, this is the sunnah and it has a hadith, no problem. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Like the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sometimes he recited Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Surah al-Fatiha, and mostly he doesn't recite it loudly. So, and Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, they choose not to recite it loudly. And Umar al-Khattab and Uthman, what they want. But Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned loudly, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Alhamdulillah rabbil alamin. Also, my beloved brothers and sisters, as an imam, some imams, they make mistakes. After they finish salah, they remain like this. Finish salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa sallam. Then they remain to the qibla and make a dhikr. This is not the sunnah. Sunnah of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after salah, you turn to the people. Turn to the people. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned the hadith. Sometimes he turned from the right, sometimes he turned from left. SubhanAllah. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's so kind. Some sahaba that went in the right, they love to see Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he stayed there first. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he come like this sometimes. Also, sometimes like this. Left. And I try to sometimes to do it, to tell people this way and this way is correct. And don't, sometimes people interpret the hadith wrongly. To the right and sometimes to the left. They sit to the side. It's not correct. That's not what Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam meant. Even he said, he turned to the right, he turned to the left. So they interrupt right and left to give your side to the right or side to the left, which is not correct. The right understanding that you can turn from the right way to the people or the left way to the people. So this is the according to the hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sharing with you some sunnahs mentioned in the hadith. Any question? Yes.
What of the praying of the sunnah? A lot of times one may have a thinking of praying only the impact and then maybe.
Yeah, very important, my beloved brothers and sisters, to not miss a great reward. Great reward. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, whomever performs salah 12 rak'ah other than the obligatory salah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will build for him a house in Jannah, a house in paradise. So 12 rak'ah is 2 rak'ah before Fajr. And this is the highest recommended. The highest recommended 2 rak'ah, light one, not long one. Very light. Quick rak'ah, 2 rak'ah before Fajr. This is حديث it has a special حديث from الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم ركعتي الفجر خير من الدنيا وما فيها. The two ركعه for the فجر is better than this dunya and whatever in it. يعني whatever things valuable in this dunya put it together, this two ركعه is better than that. Okay? Four ركعة before ظهر, two ركعة after ظهر is correct. Four ركعة before ظهر, four ركعة after ظهر also better. Huh? Then two ركعة after مغرب, two ركعة after عشاء. This is the sunnah. Sunnah. Also recommended the sunnah to do it at home if you are able. But if you know, you will forget to do at home, better you do in the masjid. You understand? Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم, he gave us advice. لا تجعلوا بيوتكم مقابر. Don't make your house like a graveyard. All you salah in the masjid, in the house no salah. You understand? So if you ask me, brother, which is better, I pray sunnah in the masjid or at home? Better if you sure you pray sunnah at home. But if you in the middle of the way you have to stop to restaurant, you have to buy this, you have to do, then you arrive home, you already miss sunnah. Better you pray at home at the masjid. Alhamdulillah, people here, I see them, they more worried about the sunnah. They pray at masjid to make sure that they will not miss the sunnah. That's good. But make some time, some salawat at home. At least houses, malaika there, barakah there. Not always salah in the masjid, in the house, no salah. You understand? You understand, sisters, the sunnah, iman. Important of sunnah. Sister, important of sunnah at home. Very important. And witr is really, really highly recommended. To don't miss any sunnah or salah. Okay. All right, brothers and sisters, let's watch this quick video to refresh your memory. Please focus.
Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was flown from his house in Mecca to Jerusalem, mounted on al-Buraq, which traveled at speeds of light.
When he arrived in Jerusalem, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam led the previous prophets in prayer at Masjid al-Aqsa. After ascending to the heavens, it was there that the prayer was established and made compulsory.
Still today, the nation of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam hear and answer the call to prayer, await and thank, praise, and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.